Your headliner, his first time ever on stage, please, let's get a nice round warm of applause. Round warm of applause. Warm round of applause. It's been a long night. For your friend, right? Come on.
You try and meet people and your friends tell you, you can meet people on Facebook. And I'm like, you know what, I'm a romantic person. Like, I don't want to be the guy 4 years down the road, my grandkids are like, baby, grandpa, how do you meet grandma? I'm like, well, we have 57 Facebook friends in common, so I took her to the coffee shop. But then nowadays, well, how do you hook up with people? You go to their club. And it's funny, like, how you can go into the club here in New York's the worst place to go to the club because girls have attitude. And now, how do you dance with a girl? You come up to them and you're like, that's your dance move. But then when you go up to girls in the club, now in New York, they start off speaking loud and fast and they slow down and get quiet. But you know, sometimes you get like a whammy one where it's like a pop-up party, just, you see like a hairy situation. You open up like, you hear like some like African tribal music, you open up and it's like, I'm on my way, oh. It's like a scene from The Lion King. Is that Simba on top of your cliff? He's getting annoyed. Oh shit. Let me get the camera. But nah, it's funny when you fuck a girl for the first time, I'm the type of person where I get nervous. Because, you know, you want to be good for the first time. But then sometimes girls, you make us so nervous because you'll say something like, I've never been with an Hispanic person before. I'm like, fuck, now I gotta fuck you for my whole nationality? You're like, if I don't fuck you good enough, it's gonna be like, you're gonna be on the BBM with your white girlfriend. Yeah, Hispanic people? Nah. I got the video. It was 23 minutes long. You ever get the phone call from your girlfriend though? And she's like, baby, I need you to go to CVS. And you're like, fuck! There's nothing I can possibly buy you from CVS that could be good. Like, what the fuck can I buy you from CVS that could be good? She's like a home pregnancy test. I'm like, fuck. Well, I mean, deep down inside, I was like, eh. At least I thought you were going to say we need a condom, that would fucking suck. I haven't used condom since the 90s. You fucking know what I'm talking about. She's like, damn, why do I need a condom now? I didn't need it last week. Damn, now I'm fucking drawing a blank. Let me try to fucking think. See what happens when you get nervous and your fucking headline, your last... Huh? Oh yeah, the pregnancy test. All right. Yeah, so you don't buy the pregnancy test at CVS, and you come up to the clerk, and the clerk manages to ask you a question, tell you a statement, and sum that shit up in one word. She'd be like, you're unsure? I'm like, yeah, well, I'm unsure. Why would I be buying a pregnancy test if I'm unsure? Like, why would I waste the $10? But you know what, it's bad because the clerks always, like, investigate your purchases and they gauge what you're buying. So the home pregnancy test is appropriate on CVS. Because when you buy the home pregnancy test, it tells the clerk, listen, clerk, I fucked somebody recently and that shit was fucking good. A lot of people think you buy condoms and it makes you look cool. It's like, you're not badass, I'm buying condoms, I'm not badass. Meanwhile, that just tells the clerk, listen, I might fuck somebody, I don't trust them, they might have an STD, so fuck it. Give me some condoms. But, I'm just gonna end it on a fucking true story, because I forgot most of the rest of my act. But I'm gonna end it on a true story. So anyway, I was actually an extra in a Rescue Me TV show recently, and it was funny because we were all chilling outside of the restaurant, like 20 of us, and you know how New Yorkers like to instigate shit. So there's a cab driving by, somebody runs out of the fucking cab, and the cab driver chases him, and he was Arabic. He's like, motherfucker, this motherfucker didn't pay me my money. And you know, we're like, fuck him up. And then so he comes and he starts telling us his life story, like, we give a fuck, but we don't. But we listen just because we want to instigate. I'm like, damn, what happened? He's like, motherfucker, I'm coming from 53rd and 3rd here, fucking downtown. I'm like, oh shit. I was like, well, listen, man, I gotta go to 80th and 3rd. You think you can take me? So he fucking takes me. He's telling me his story. I'm telling him all kinds of shit. I'm like, listen, this is my stand back. He loves me. And fucking ironically, we get stuck at a light on 53rd and 3rd. And he's like, this is where this motherfucker did not pay me. I'm like, you know what? I'm about to change this guy's life. Cause he got one fucked up story, I'm about to turn it into a fucked up funny story. So, I just open the door and I'm like, fuck you, motherfucker! And